Hello everybody, my name is Gade and I will talk about the Master Program Tourism Destination Management at BUAS. And BUAS is an abbreviation for Breda University of Applied Sciences, which is based in the Netherlands. So a little bit about me and about the Master Program Tourism Destination Management. I will first talk about like why I chose this master. I chose this master because I'm very interested in how tourism is developing and how destinations can adapt towards like on tourism, but also how they can regulate tourism. So which is basically what I'm learning at the moment at this master program. Some information about the program itself. Tourism Destination Management is a program which will eventually is a Master of Arts. So that is going to be the diploma at the end. It's a fully English taught study program, which also means that you're studying in an international, in a cross-cultural environment. So the students as well as the staff will be international. As you can see, the class will consist of approximately 40 students, and like more than half of them is coming from abroad, so it's not Dutch. But also the staff, as I mentioned, is coming from so many different countries and cultures, so it's a very international program. I will give some information about the curriculum. It's a one-year full-time program, which starts in September every year. And the program consists out of three phases. And I will, later on, I will discuss every phase in more detail. And it's a program which combines actually the social aspects of tourism, but it is also a management program. So you will also have some managerial classes such as marketing. And we really have like the applied learning in here. So, which means that we do not have exams, like multiple choice exams, no. We will be tested by doing practical assignments. We work in projects, you will do essays, but we also give presentations. So that's how we get tested. And we work a lot in groups. There are also some individual assignments, but also a lot of group projects are involved in the study program. And the lecturers, they're coming from the industry, so they're really professionals in tourism and have different experiences in the tourism industry. And you will also get some guest lectures, international guest lectures from all around the world. So you will get taught a lot of different subjects, a lot of different learning methods within the Tourism Destination Management course. So now we'll first talk about phase one. Phase one starts from September until, let's say, the end of January. And in phase one, you will be at Breda, at BUAS, you will be studying here. And you will get different types of courses. Here are the seven courses that you will get. And as you can see, there are like some marketing and management courses, such as contemporary marketing, context and trends. But of course, you will also get research courses, and you will learn how you should write your thesis at the end of the year. But also how to do research within tourism, different methods. But we also have some other courses, like for example, cross-cultural studies, because we work in a very international environment with different cultures, of course. And well, since we're working together often, we also have the course team performance and creative leadership. And the last two courses, of course, more specific about destinations, because that is, of course, what this whole master is about destination management in tourism. So, of course, you need to know more about the development and the involved stakeholders and finance. So these are all the courses that you will get during the first phase. And then we go to the second phase of the curriculum of the year. And the second phase is always the phase to which everybody is super excited, because this is the phase where we will be doing field research for 3 full months. And you will be doing the field research in Australia and Southeast Asia. And as you can see on the map, these are the destinations so far where the study program has been. And usually you go to one destination in Australia, so it could be Melbourne, for example, for 1 month. And then the second month you can go, you're going to Cambodia or Vietnam, for example, or it could also be Sri Lanka, Thailand. And the last month you're going to Bali. And you're not going alone, no, you're going with the full class. So all the 40 TDM students with some supervisors are going to this field research. And what you're gonna learn in this field research, you're going to work in groups again. And at every destination, you're going to do specific research for one specific stakeholder. So this could be a hotel company, it could be a taxi driver, it could be a shop. It is a stakeholder which is dealing with tourism, of course. So you will be doing a research for that stakeholder in that specific destination. And you will see different destinations, so which is why we're also are changing every month to a new destination. So you, at the end, you will have visited an urban destination, an emerging tourism destination, and a developed tourism destination. So this is very a fun part where you really put all the knowledge that you've learned doing phase one, you will put it into practice during phase two. So you're really going to apply your knowledge. So yeah, and then of course there's phase three, and phase three is the course that you will have to write your dissertation, or others say thesis, it's the same thing, but you will not start in phase three with it. No, you already start with your dissertation in phase one, so you will be already halfway with your thesis when you are coming back from the field trip in phase two. So you will be probably be coming back around May, somewhere beginning of May. And then it's time to go further with your thesis, your dissertation. And you can write it anywhere in the world. You can write it in the Netherlands, you can write it in Asia, or in your, or from your home country. You can write it anywhere. And the topic is of your choice. As long as, of course, it has to do with tourism and a destination. So the research topic could be totally like your own choice. You can make it really your own research, and you have to do it individually. So this is really your last project, your end thesis. And then afterwards, you will be graduated, hopefully. So what then? If you're graduated, what are some career opportunities? Now here I've listed some opportunities on the slide. Like these are some examples that previous TDM students ended up with. So first you see like they've very often students like to work at destination marketing organizations, or otherwise called DMOs. But you could also work at TripAdvisor, MBTC Holland Marketing, the Ministry of Tourism, airlines, you name it. It's super broad. Also, it can be anywhere in the world again. And I also have some functions that you can think of when you have completed this master. It could be more an advisory function, but it could also be more like a managerial function, or some people would like to go more into the marketing side. But of course, there is also a very big need for sustainability advisors, because tourism is trying to become more sustainable in a way. So in the long term, that we can still have tourism, because nowadays you also hear, of course, the phenomenon over tourism. So yeah, these are very important topics that you will learn all about during this master program. So studying at TDM, I listed here some characteristics of like what type of student would suit this management program really well. Now, of course, at first you should be very interested in the management side of tourism, and of course in specific like destinations, you should really be interested in how destinations are all differently dealing with tourism. But of course, you should also be really open-minded. We're going abroad, you're going to get to learn new cultures, new people. So you should be an open-minded person as well. You should also be ready to go out of your comfort zone, you know. And of course, you should be able, or you should really like to work in an international classroom. You should be interested in different cultures, getting to know different cultures. And last but not least, you should also be a team player as well, what I already mentioned, because lots of assignments are in teams, in project groups, which also means that they're very practical assignments. Like I already mentioned, you should, if you want to study this master program, you should really like to put everything you learn into practice, because that's really what we're doing this year. So then finally, I want to thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, you can of course reach us via our website and social media channels. I'm also happy to answer all your questions, and maybe I will see you next year on campus. Bye!